many people use a WebSDR to augment their own receive station, often for geographical diversity, and other times because of the noise situation of their QTH. CW operators sometimes find the WebSDR to be useful for these same reasons. If you have operated CW on different makes of radios over the years, you know that there are several standards to choose from. Many older American-made radios receive CW using USB, with a dial or display indicating the zero-beat frequency, leaving the operator to do the mental math to calculate the transmit frequency of the other station. Meanwhile, many monitor radios change the dial frequency or shift the tuning such that it displays the transmitted frequency of the station being received, if the station is tuned in such that its pitch matches the transmitter's side tone. What is not consistent is whether or not upper or lower sideband is used for CW reception. The WebSDRs follow the convention of the more modern radios in that when you switch to CW, the displayed frequency changes to that of the transmitted frequency of the station being received, but it also uses only lower sideband by default. What's more, the displayed frequency is only correct if you happen to tune the signal such that the received tone is 750 Hz. While this type of tuning is common on many modern radios, it can confuse first-time users, or those not familiar with the way typical radios work when receiving CW. We sometimes get comments or complaints that the receiver seems to shift off-frequency when in this mode, but in reality, this is exactly the way most modern radios work. You can prove this to yourself by tuning in a CW signal while using lower sideband, but make sure that the pitch of the received tone is between 500 and 900 Hz. Switching to CW wide, you'll note that the pitch of the received signal doesn't change, but the displayed frequency does, by exactly 750 Hz. Incidentally, if you wish to use upper sideband CW reception on the Northern Utah WebSDR, check the USB CW box, or include ?USB CW in the URL, and this will cause USB to be used instead. Note that this feature is not available on most WebSDRs. When using a transceiver, the side tone provides an audible reference as to the pitch which you should tune the other signal, but with WebSDRs, there is no such side tone. But the Northern Utah WebSDR, and a few other WebSDRs, have a few features that might help with this. A feature found on some modern radios is the CW peaking filter, an adjustable, moderately sharp bandpass filter that provides a degree of filtering, but it isn't a brick wall filter, which allows you to hear, in the background, other signals that might be present. To enable this filter, locate the CW peak slider located a bit below the WebSDR's on-screen volume control. From the off position, when the slider is at its far left stop, slide it to the right. You'll see the displayed frequency of the filter change, and hear the effects of this filter as this is done. If you set the peaking filter to 750 Hz, and then tune the signals so that they are centered in it, the display will correctly show the RF frequency of the transmitted signal. A feature of the CW peak filter that might be useful to some operators is the reference tone. To the right of the CW peak's frequency display is a checkbox, and activating this will cause a tone to be produced at precisely the frequency that is shown. This can be used as a reference while tuning signals. DSP noise reduction may also be useful for CW operation. This filter works by detecting coherent energy within the receiver's passband, like a CW signal, and removing everything else. One caveat to this filter is that when a signal first appears, it takes a brief moment to learn about that signal, which may be something to consider when someone replies to your transmission. It should go without saying that the Notch 1 or Notch 2 filters should never be used for reception of CW or digital signals, as their job is to lock on and remove tones. Importantly, there is the filtering of the WebSDR itself. When you first start using the WebSDR, it's recommended that you start with CW wide, as it's broad enough to allow you to find signals easily. Once you have tuned in a signal, you may then switch to one of the narrow filters, which allows strong, adjacent frequencies to be rejected and prevents them from causing receiver descents through AGC action. Remember, though, that these filters assume that you are tuning the received signals for a 750 Hz tone. You can zoom in on the waterfall display and drag the filter bars to create a filter with your own preferred bandwidth, or you can use the controls in the passband tuning section of the display to incrementally make similar adjustments. Finally, new users should be aware of the tuning controls located just below the frequency entry bar and the mode display. On the Northern Utah WebSDR, These display the amount by which the current tuning will be changed if you click on one of these buttons, and these buttons offer much finer and more repeatable tuning that is possible by using the mouse to drag the receiver's marker around the waterfall. Thanks for watching.